So let's do a deeper dive into the IOTA VX SA3. Let's compare the DAC, the internal DAC, to an external one, in this case, the Modi 3. So what you do get with the Modi 3 is more definition, more separation. The layering is better. The internal DAC in the SA3, it kind of lays things on a bit thicker. It's still very, very good. You just don't get that extra degree of separation that you do from the external DAC here, which is the Modi 3. And I'll even throw out, it was actually night and day. I usually say the difference is not night and day. You do notice that extra degree of micro detail coming from the Modi 3. So as much as I hate adding extra equipment to something that's already functional, if you wanna kinda do a little upgrade to your SA3, try getting the $99 Modi 3. Now, this is the Modi 3. Now, Scheidt has the Modi 3 Plus, which has Unison USB. Now, I was planning on selling the entire Scheidt stack that I had, but I'm definitely keeping the Modi 3 now after comparing. So next on the list, let's compare the phono stages or phono preamps. This one has an internal one built in. Here's an external one from Scheidt. It's called the Manny again. And we are also going to compare it to the phono stage in the X7. So which one is the winner here? Simply put, the IOTA VX SA3 is the winner by a mile. There's much more body, much more clarity from the SA3 compared to the Manny or the X7. So comparatively with my setup, the Manny sounds a bit thin. It doesn't have the body or nearly the amount of clarity that the SA3 provides from the phono stage. And the same goes with the X7. It was actually the worst in clarity. I did not like using it as a phono stage at all. But yeah, it was an interesting test for me because I kind of thought they'd all sound the same, but now I can kind of see why people spend a lot of money for some quality phono stage preamps out there. So I know the number of people out there using the headphone jacks of their integrated amps are probably slim. Actually, I have no idea, but I know you people are out there, so this test is for you. I compared the X7 initially to the SA3 and also the Felix Euphoria, and I have to say, out of everything here, the most surprising part of this was how well the X7 performed. And I know the X7 line is created in the same factory as Line Magnetic Amps, a much more premium brand, and they also kind of share the same technology with K&N. So that's why I decided to bring the K&N HA6A into the mix. It is a dedicated headphone amplifier. This is an integrated amp. So while they have different goals, they actually have pretty similar sound signatures. So while they do sound similar, the HA6A costs about twice as much as the X7. And right off the bat, I'm gonna tell you that the X7 doesn't sound as clean as the K&N, but the power and dynamics are still very much there. When talking distinctly about headphones, when the X7 is in ultra-linear mode, there is noise and hum galore, unfortunately. I kept both of them in ultra-linear for most of my tests, just because I felt there's more clarity and there's more power, so we can do a more fair comparison compared to the SA3 here. And as for the noise and hum, switching the X7 to triode mode actually eliminates most of the noise that I was hearing. It's still there, but it's very faint and it doesn't really interrupt your listening experience. So compared to the K&N, the X7 definitely has more distortion. And let me tell you, that's actually pleasing on some level. If you're looking for an experience that's more true to life when it comes to like live music per se, you'll get that much better on the X7. Everything sounds more spacious. The sound stage is definitely bigger on the X7. And that massive sense of scope actually gave me such a pleasant surprise. Enough to where I actually thought maybe I should just use the X7 for all my headphone listening and just get rid of the HA6A. Upon more testing though, the K&N simply wins out for clarity and separation. There's noticeably less distortion and the sound just sounds overall cleaner. Comfortably Numb by Pink Floyd, it has a string section and this is presented thicker and seemingly more compressed and blended together on the X7. But this same part of the song is presented beautifully with better separation and detail on the HA6A. The mid-range, upper mids, and top end are much more fleshed out on the K&N. And let's quickly talk about the bass on the X7 when you're talking about dynamic headphones. It feels like dynamics are getting a sub-bass jolt when hooking up to the X7. So when you're comparing to every other amp here, including the Euphoria, it seems like those other amps are seemingly bass light compared to the Musishare here. But even though there's more of it on the X7, the other options here, any other option, they'll present the bass and the lower frequencies with better definition and clarity versus just kind of mushing it together and cranking it up on the X7. And I have to say, even though the definition of the lower frequencies aren't here, it doesn't mean that you won't enjoy your experience. I had a blast listening to this on my headphones. It just depends what irks you. Like if you're looking for super crisp definition on the lower end frequencies, I know we all kind of are, but you probably won't notice as much unless you're directly comparing it like I was with all these other amps. If you just had this by itself, you'd just jam away with your headphones and you'd have a blast. What I later found was I prefer Dynamics with the X7, while I found that Planars really mated well with the HA6A as it's more powerful and more resolving. And lastly, I know we mentioned build quality before with the X7, and I have to bring it up here. The inconsistency of using this with headphones, it kind of drove me nuts on some level. I'd plug certain headphones in, I'd get loud noise and hum on one, and the next one it wouldn't be as bad. And with this, it was just very inconsistent. Like you'll get like a random loud noise, buzz, or some other issue with the X7. Everything else seemed much more rock solid, much more stable and consistent. So take that into account as well. So now let's take the HA6A out of the mix and bring back the Felix Euphoria, since we're talking headphone comparisons. Felix Euphoria, as I mentioned before, is an OTL amp. I plan to do an OTL versus OTC amp video in the future, so we'll go more in-depth about sound comparisons there. But just for now, know that the Euphoria compared to the X7 sounds several times cleaner, much more intimate. It feels like you're closer to the music, and it really is a different experience. Albeit with less dynamics and power than the X7 here. The IOTA VX sound is very clean, not overly analytical, but still quick and precise, at least compared to the tube amps, with just enough flavor to keep it engaging. The sound signature is on the warmer side of neutral, but not by very much. The biggest downside to the SA3's headphone output here is the lack of dynamics. You don't get that really big bass slam or impact that you do from the other amps here. And there's a noticeable lack of definition or sparkle at the very top end of the frequency range. I'm guessing this is due to the SA3 outputting much less power out of the headphone output here, because it simply sounds anemic when you're AB comparing to the other amps here. Even with the 32 ohm Empyreans, which usually excel on solid state amps, I actually really preferred it on the tube options here. The one shout out I'll give to the SA3 was classical music. The clean and crisp nature of solid state in general works in the SA3's favor, and I really very much like listening to any headphone on the SA3 when it came to classical. But yeah, overall, if we're comparing just integrated amps, the headphone output on the X7, to me, it's much more preferable, despite all the issues I had with it when it came to noise. If I was just here on my own time, not doing a review or anything, I would instantly plug any headphone I had into this over using the SA3.